Well, that was not so hard. You just have to learn to play with it, I guess. And as a small reminder, we are just, you know, fighting our nightmares and our depression, so it makes sense that that's a creator, whatever that was. Now let me lower the music a little bit. So the boss is not hard, but I think you have to time your attacks to reach the mines or either to hit him while he's in the water, but it's a little easier to use the mines and the time slow. Anyway, I showed you a lot of options to kill him, and now I guess they'll have to buff him up because he's a little easier than I expected after I know how to handle him. Now I get a toy tank? What? Okay, I guess you have more health right now because we have the toy tank, which is like a keepsake, which is like a perk. Yeah, this is exactly like the binding of Isaac. We have the perks and we have the gear. As you can see, I only got a measure this time. Not a lot of useful items, but the slingshot is very, very strong. The frost fracture. Anyway, my defense is kind of low this game, so I got another key from the developers, and now I can play the second level of the prologue, which is awesome because I have a lot of stuff to unlock. So Hometown, part 1 of 2. Okay, let's wake up. Now, I don't know exactly how I access the other one. Wait. We can craft a few things. Now, I still don't have all the unlockables because I need to craft and, you know, give sketch of a mighty heroine. Now, the way the developers want us to finish this is to see the notes. So Eve, she loves traveling. Alison loves fantasy. So Tamua likes hiking and hip-hop. So let's see what we can craft that has hiking or hip-hop. Prehistoric joke collection. Rustic mug. Well, he would love that, but I guess we can't do it anymore. We don't have enough of the cool things. Cool beat poem. Can't do that either. Raid Haven. I don't know what's that. Probably the city we're living in. Okay, so we can't do anything for him. So what can we craft? I wish they would add something that shows you how many you can craft or which one you can craft. Now let me think about it, because I want to give someone a gift. Postcard of Raid Haven it is then. Well, I guess they'll appreciate this as well. Okay, let's just give it to Tamal, because since he loves traveling, maybe he'll enjoy the gift of his own hometown. And if we do it like this, we'll unlock more items for us. So we can... What? Alison is here. So we can even... Yeah, whatever. You can have the postcard. Because if we talk to them, I mean, if... I don't know. It's kind of a silly thing in my opinion, because it's... If you talk to people and get to know them... You're wearing a shirt from one of my favorite comics. Yeah, right. If you talk to them and they become friends with you, you actually beat your depression or whatever your phobia is, and then you can make some friends, and then you're stronger in your nightmares. That's why they made this little system. So the more you think about it, the more it makes sense. And I don't know, I'm not the one for soft and pleasant in video games, especially in ones which I have a big sword and a finger gun or whatever I had. And the dialogue is kind of long, but it's heartwarming, and I know, I'm not really in the mood for this type of, you know, reading, because I read so much about it, I saw so many movies about it, but probably a lot of younger people will enjoy it. Sure, what did I unlock? Comics, yes. Exquisite, interesting, very good, Alison, okay, happy to meet you. So we unlocked cold snap and coffee. Now, I think the point is to do this every day and go, this is the bookshop, let's go to the cafe and speak with everyone. Yeah, for a few minutes and then go back to the bar and speak with everyone here for a few minutes as well. Yeah, famous rapper. Who was that? I don't know. Too bad we can't do a barrel roll over here. Okay, enough socializing. That's 3 hours of socializing. Now we just need to go home and hit the bed. Now, as you can see, we have a bit more unlocks, but we still have a very long, long way to go. Coffee. Now, I'm curious, the developer said that the key was for another level, but I'm not sure how you select your level or what changes if you have that code. I don't know, I'll read more into it. Oh, okay. So this is the second level. I don't know if. Anyway, as I said, I'm playing the early access version of the prologue, which should be free, which should be launching in 2 weeks. So I'm not really sure what I'm doing over here, but let's have some fun. Oh, the hammer is not a good weapon. I'm not. What? Oh, okay. Sorry, I didn't notice the huge pile of bricks laying in the middle of the road. Ah, forget it. Yeah, it's hard to fight with weapons you don't really understand or know. So I guess your best option is to fight with weapons you already know. Yeah, the hammer is so slow. I mean, I only took it because I wanted to kill the fish faster. Otherwise, I would prefer the katana or the baseball bat. Man, these guys are no joke. The controls are also a bit stiff. Well, might as well. Fortunately for me, they do give you a lot of healing items. Okay, so. Oh, come on, you want some more? Okay, finally, that was a bit harder than I imagined. I guess this is the part of her dreams where she's in the city. Good, some crafting items, always helpful. Now, I also got a bomb. So let's blow these things up. Now, what I'm actually looking for is health. Okay, we can play. I guess I can play for a little longer. Now, this is the coffee house. Oh, 950. What's this? This is a skill. I need to use my skills more often. Detonate. Finger gun, level 4. That's so good. Or I can just buy something that I don't have and actually make it better. Yeah, you have a lot of choices in the game. This is what I like about it. Sorry about talking so much, but I'm a bit, I don't know, in love with the game. If I hold, I can recycle this and I'll get. Yeah, give me the sand because I want more currency. It's such a fluent game and it's such a beautiful artwork. And of course, the idea of the game is very good. But like I said, I'm a brute sometimes. I'm also pressing the special attack and it triggers my special ability, which is on Q. Kind of weird, but I guess I understand. Oh, it's so hard to aim with the ability. I don't know. Maybe it'll be better when you play with the controller or something. I don't know, but it's a little harder to do. The city. Okay, let's do that again because the hammer is a really, really bad weapon. I'm used to heavy to lighter weapons that deal a lot more damage, but that? No, I can't chit-chat. Oh, because I don't have time. Oh well, then sleep it is. We all love sleep. So let's again try this out. Yeah, I also have to stop talking when I'm playing the game, because this is a roguelike game. It's not one of those games that you can, you know, play when you have the mood. Oh, and it starts me over here again? Oh, so I have to play this level all over again. Okay, nice. So I got the knife. Okay, so that was my first time reaching that area. And I totally got smashed by it. Yeah, I have this on the mouse button, the special ability, and it seems like it triggers it. Oh, finally he's dead. The game actually features some puzzle rooms, so let me see if I can show you some other rooms that we haven't seen. No, don't buy that. Hello, my friendly ghost on the bench. Hey, you hit me, you monster. Yeah, I need to work on my aiming a little bit, because the game has kind of like a console command scheme. For example, you have to walk in that direction, but you'll never aim it in... it's very hard to aim in the diagonal, that's what I'm trying to say. So it's better for me to line up my shots on a straight line. And then just combo them to death. Yeah, that works a lot better. Now let's see if I can find those mystical rooms, especially the puzzle room. I want to show you that one. Oh, that's a large health potion. Let's leave it there. Oh, and this is the one that gives you a lot of sand. Okay, nice. Oh, it actually gives me a shield. Okay, let's swap that. And then recycle that one. Yeah, the game is so much better after you play it for a while. I'm a bit disappointed that I lost the level so fast because I didn't knew what the enemies did. But it appears that you have to be relatively well prepared for that zone. Okay, see, this is the problem sometimes. I mean, you could block all of them, or if you try to aim with your mouse, it doesn't work. And this will get you in a lot of trouble sometimes, because I don't know, maybe a lock-on function would be a little better. Because it's a little hard to hit the enemies in the diagonal, so if it's a straight line, I have no problems. Small health potion, okay. But yeah, basically I can finish the first area in about 15 minutes. Well, the boss can take 5 minutes, so let's say 15 minutes up to 20 minutes. Also, let's use my bow. Actually, aiming with the bow is a little better. Well, you still get hit because melee weapons are still the best. But yeah, combat is pretty fluid. But I can see the developers are trying to make this mostly melee game. Your ranged weapon will never be your main weapon, that's for sure. Okay, where are the... Okay, here they are. Such a lovely sound. Oh, this is the boss room. Now, I want to see if I can leave the boss room. Yeah, you can even leave the boss room. So imagine this, you have so many options. It is truly a modern roguelike asymmetric RPG. Double Jeopardy. Yeah, you deal more damage, but you receive more damage. Finger gun, detonate. The finger gun takes a long while to load. That's why I'm not really using it. So if you want to use the finger gun, just remember it's like Yu Yu Hakusho. He needs to charge up his power a little bit before he shoots. What? Okay, so yeah. I need to get used to this. So easy to combo the attacks once you get... I mean, it's so easy to aim with the attacks. If I can actually hit them the first time. Well, I guess it's never easy to make a game like this. So, yeah, it will be hard for them to balance all these things out. See? I mean, the enemy can auto-track me, but I can't really track them. And there is also no cover in the game, so most of the times I'll just get hit like that. Yeah, that's a fast way to do it. Okay, a little bomb here. Yes, yeah, so fast and so fluid. Now, I guess if you unlock more stuff, you get better weapons, because once I have the baseball bat, which sent the enemies flying away. Yeah, whatever, doesn't really matter. Now, let's see what's behind the magic door. I hope it's a puzzle. No, it's not a puzzle. So, this is actually a full heal room. Which is nice, because they really think of everything. Yeah, that was a parry, by the way. Let's exercise the parry a little more. Yeah, exercise is the only thing that will make you better in the game. Now there is a guaranteed market on each level, so let's see why. Oh, what's this so expensive? Successful parry increases your movement speed. Radiant Shield is actually one of my favorite ones, and looks like they have some special modifiers sometimes. Sand. And global damage. Health recovery, yeah. Also, don't forget to recycle your shield. Huh. Actually, buy another thing if we wanted. Well, another health potion. Anyway, that's kind of what I wanted to show you, and I'll play more to show you the second level, probably the second boss, once I get a little better at it and I play with all the weapons, especially the knife and the hammer. Bye!